Yeah, he is very, very injured there, so we're going to leave him be. I can see Pete coming along here, so we might just back up and let him be, because he has definitely been in a bit of a battle this morning, which sadly is how it works in the hippo world. But boy, he's definitely... definitely been knocked about. Hey mate.
Good morning.
How are you, buddy?
Okay,
good. That's pretty serious, isn't it?
Very serious. Quite sad to observe.
Absolutely. Really sad.
We've spent a bit of time with him. They were fighting a bit down at the waterhole. I presume you guys are going to look at this now. It's hard to look at the...
Well, we're probably going to just move on, let him be, because I think maybe he's going to get just under more stress by... He's in a vulnerable position in just being out of the water at this time of the day anyway, isn't he? So he's not feeling very comfortable, and compounded with the injuries that he's got, he's not in a good way.
I think similar. It's exactly what I was saying just now.
Is it? Is it?
I'm going to put too much pressure on him, obviously, as HD's explaining to you guys. It's he walked past us at the waterhole. It's worse than you can see from
here.
But on his shoulder, it's a really big gash, and then his back as well. But it's old injuries, it's not new.
Yeah, there's a big, good lot of scar tissue around that.
The back leg especially, but this other bull put a lot of pressure on him. We saw some of it just to give you a catch up from what we experienced at the waterhole. And a definite, clear indication from the bull that is in Gowrie waterhole that he doesn't want him around. So he's probably an old guy that picks out injured in the process, and he's at that sort of sad, sort of last part of.
Yeah, he's definitely in a... He's been he's an old boy. You can see by his injuries just on his spinal column as well. It's quite exposed. And you do see that, folks, when you get an older animal that is sort of getting to the end of its time. The spinal column and the hips and everything will be more prominent, won't they?
He's old and he's got lots of scars. I mean, he's been... Yeah, we could look at the upside. He's had a great full life.
Many
hippos running around with his genes.
Oh, absolutely. Around their absolutely. Body,
so. But he's
a bit quiet this morning, mate.
A little bit quiet. We had leopard tracks, and it's worth your while just to know we had the tracks. That little track that goes down to Gowrie waterhole. We had the tracks there. We had the tracks on here as well, coming this way. We didn't find tracks leaving to the south or the north, which is obviously doesn't mean they could have left. But I've got a strong feeling. The canoe is still somewhere
around,
so just need a little bit of luck.
Okay, we're just going to have a little a little poke around in
enjoy, and then obviously lovely giraffe, which I'm sure you're enjoying.
Yeah, well, you've had a nice little encounter with him this morning, haven't you? Absolutely.
Tiny little guy.
Yeah, just lying down over there.
And
I think we're going to leave this area just for the simple reason, folks, just to give this hippo some space.
I'm going to say cheers. So,
all right, mate. I'll see you later, mate. Take care. See you later, Brian.
Enjoy it.
Cheers, mate. Yeah, really sad, folks. Hippo dominancy is an incredibly vicious, vicious sort of affair, state of affairs, and he's not in a good way. So we're just going to let him be and go off and do what he needs to do. But he's in a very, very bad way, but he's an old animal, and we'll just let him be. Got loads of scar tissue on him, loads of battle scars. He needs to go off and find a place where he can just try and get better, but I am sorry to say, I think that those wounds could end up being his last time he battles, unfortunately.